So the next paper is by Dr. Puneet Jain, and he's going to talk about ocular surface squamous neoplasia in xeroderma pigmentosa.
Thank you. A very good morning to all of you. I shall be sharing a case series of ocular squamous neoplasia in xeroderma pigmentosum patients. As we all know, xeroderma pigmentosum is an autosomal recessive disease characterized by oculocutaneous and CNS manifestations, the primary defect being a defective nucleoride excision repair pathway, which predisposes these patients to cutaneous malignancies in sun-exposed areas as well as ocular surface malignancies. The incidence of the disease per se is variable all across the globe, and the incidence in India has not been reported yet. The patient usually presents with cutaneous manifestations within first 2 years of life. The ocular involvement is reported for more than 40% patients, to as high as 100% patients in xeroderma pigmentosum with definitive visual impairment. The ocular manifestations range from eyelid tumors, conjunctival xerosis, limbal stem cell deficiency, corneal opacity, pterygium, pseudopterygium, neoplasias, conjunctival and uveal melanomas. The retinal involvement is uncommon. The incidence of OSSN in XP is not known yet, and there is limited literature on clinical features, management and outcomes of OSSN in XP. So we did a retrospective review of medical records of 46 eyes of 35 patients of xeroderma pigmentosum with OSSN from 2005 to 2017. So the mean age of presentation was 13.3 plus minus 12 years. 37% of our patients presented to us in the first decade. There was a male preponderance with 69% of the patients being males, and 11 cases were bilateral. The most common presenting complaint was photophobia in 74% patients, followed by a mass lesion in the eye. Over half of the patients had both conjunctival as well as corneal involvement. So this is a clinical picture of a localized OSSN with prominent feeder vessels. This is a patient who had isolated corneal involvement, and this is a patient with diffuse OSSN. So the OSSN characteristics, 89% eyes had intrinsic vascularity and episcleral feeder vessels, and 85% eyes had Rose Bengal stain positive, which could be very evident or could be very subtle as in the second picture. Systemically, all patients were stable, two were retropositive. Out of the 12 patients who had preauricular lymphadenopathy, only one patient was FNAC proven to have squamous cell carcinoma. Our primary management included excision biopsy in 67% of the eyes, followed by excentration in 5 eyes, topical chemotherapy in 4 eyes, extended enucleation in 2 eyes, and subconjunctival interferon alpha-2b injection in 1 eye. So this is a 13-year-old boy who presented to us with recurrent OSSN, excision biopsy done elsewhere. He underwent excision biopsy with 4 millimeter clear margins with alcohol-assisted keratoepithelectomy for the corneal component, with conjunctival edge double feastraw cryotherapy, with amniotic membrane wad with tissue glue. This is the patient at 9 months follow-up. This is a 20-year-old patient, one-eyed patient presented to us with excentration done elsewhere. So we went ahead and we gave 3 weekly subconjunctival interferon injections to the patient, and after 4 injections, this is the follow-up of the patient. The excentrated patients were rehabilitated cosmetically with excentration processes. So at a mean follow-up about 18.9 months plus minus 24.2 months, 40 eyes had complete regression, that is 87% patient eyes had complete regression, 4 eyes had residual lesion and 2 eyes had recurrence. There was no patient with systemic metastasis in our series. So OSSN, as we all know, we related to an old age disease, average age being reported as 56 years. However, OSSN in xeroderma pigmentosum tends to occur at a young age. That is a known fact. In our series, no patient was over 40 years of age. 31% patients in our series were bilateral. The only reported series with a sample size of 7 patients, all being bilateral, 14 eyes, was by Gupta et al. In 2011. And they reported 7 bilateral cases. So the reported recurrence rate of OSSN per se is about 21% after excision surgery. There is limited data on recurrence of OSSN in Xenoderma pigmentosum. The same study reported a recurrence rate of about 64.3%. Our study, the recurrence rate was 4% with 5 eyes warranting excentration. So this was the paper that came out in 2011. So to conclude, OSSN occurs at an earlier age in Xenoderma pigmentosum. It tends to be bilateral and very aggressive. And currently, there is no treatment for Xenoderma pigmentosum. So periodic screening, early diagnosis, and prompt management confer a good clinical outcome. These are my references. Thank you.
Your presentation is more clinical rather than pathological. First, tell me how many patients having invasive OSSN in Xenoderma pigmentosum, and what is the ratio of non-invasive cases?
Sir, out of the 35 eye, 46 eyes, 28 eyed had invasive OSSN. About 14 eyed eyes had CIN gate 3. So, and 5 patient had orbital extension, which was seen on CT scan, which we went ahead and did excentration for.
How many patients you have tried to topical immunotherapy or chemotherapy?
Sir, 4 patients in our series received topical immunotherapy. One patient as shown in the picture, because he was a one-eyed patient, though it was a diffuse OSSN, but since he was a one-eyed patient, we went ahead with subconjunctival interferon therapy, 3 weekly injections we gave. So at the fourth month follow-up, the present picture was there. It showed good improvement.
All patients are having only OSSN in Xenoderma pigmentosum or other eyelid malignancy or periocular malignancy?
Sir, I did not include it in the series. We do have 2 patients with malignant melanoma as well. But since I restricted myself to OSSN, so I did not present it here.
You compared your series with Gupta et al, where they had 63% recurrence.
Yeah.
What was their follow-up period?
Yeah, their follow-up period was on an average 18 months, and mine was shorter, that's right.
Yeah, so I think.